Hey, what's up everyone? In this couple of lectures, we were talking about super global variables. We have already discussed what is $get, $post and $request and how we can use them in our form to transfer data and to extract data. And in this lecture, we will talk about our fourth super global variable, and that is $server. Here, I've created a new file server.php which is inside our demo directory, and that is inside the stdocs folder. So in the last lectures, we saw how we can use the $get, post and request method to transfer data by using a form and to extract data in a particular page. So in this lecture, we will see what $server actually is, how we can use $server. So basically, $server is a super global variable which gives us information about our server. Suppose you are working locally now, then it will give us information about our local server. And suppose you are working in a live project, then this $server will give information about the server in which you are working. So let's see how it works. Here you can see a form. We have a form, and in the action, we specified this file only, server.php. So that means that if we hit the submit button, then this form will get submitted in this particular page only. That means this page will refresh, okay, and will reload once again. And we are sending the data by using the post method. So let's try to first see this data, what data is coming through the form. So what we'll do, we will first write a pre tag, okay. So why we are writing this pre tag? Because it displays our array in a better way, okay, because our $post super global variable will contain all the information in a form of associative array. So we want to display it properly. That's why we are using this pre tag. And in here, let's put some PHP, and we will write an echo statement. See, we are printing an array. So to print an array, we will use the printr function, okay, printr. And in here, we will write $post, and that's it. Okay, now end this line with a semicolon. Now save this. Okay, so if I now go and refresh the browser, then we may encounter some errors. So let's see if we are getting some errors or not. So here we are in the localhost, then our demo directory, and here we can see our file. Where it is, server.php, right here. Okay, so open this. Okay, so we are not seeing any error. Fine, we can see our two input fields and the submit button, but below that we can see a blank array. The array is there, but it doesn't have any index or value, because till now we haven't passed any value to the array. Okay, so when we will pass the value, when we will put some values in this input fields, and when we will hit the submit button. So let's try that. Let's book a book title. Let's say Aladdin, and in here in the password, let's write 12345 and hit submit. Okay, so now we can see our array, and the first index is title 1 Aladdin, and the second index is secret code, and the third index is enter, and we are getting this indexes from in here. See, the first input field has the name title 1. So this is how we are using the $post or whatever $get method. Now, how we can use the $server, and what type of information will it give us? So let's see that. Let's copy this, okay, and come down here and paste it in here. And we just want to change this $post to $server. Save this and come here and again hit refresh. Okay, so it's asking me to if I want to resubmit the form or not. You can click resend or confirm, or you can do one thing, you can come here and hit enter. Okay, so we are getting a lot of things in here. Okay, so this is looking a bit messy. So let's see what we can do here. See, this pre tag is not working. So let's make it proper. Now it will display the error in a better manner. Okay, So see, we are getting a lot of information about our server. Okay, so if you focus on the informations, then here we can see that some information which we will need to deal with later on. Like see, here we have a index telling server name. Okay, and our server name is localhost. Suppose you're working in a live project, you're in live server, then here it won't display localhost. Here it will display the live server, the name of your website maybe. Okay, and see our port is, server port is 80, so it is displaying that, and we are getting a lot of information from in here, right? Here you can see the script file name we have, the total, the whole directory where our file resides, that is in dxampastydocsdemo, then our file name server.php. And in here, if you see that request URI is our demo folder, then the name of our file. And our script name is also there, that is same as the request URI. And here you can see another index, php self. So it is also the same, but we will use it in a better way. So how we can use this? So let's see that. So see, we are getting a lot of information about our server. So when you will do some advanced thing in PHP, then you will definitely use this dollar server to extract some information about the particular server in which you are working. So this is good to know. So let's use this PHP self right now and let's see where we can use this. So open your text editor and let's do one thing. Let's come here and change this. Okay. So if you notice here, see, if you notice here, then we can see that this is our file name only, correct? Demo, our folder, then our file name. So here, we are submitting the file. We are submitting this form in the same file, correct? So here we can write that PHP function, PHP self, so that it will submit the form in the same page, whatever page we are processing, and the form is in that page. If we use this PHP function in the action, then the same page will get refreshed and that form will submit in the same page. So let's write here that statement. Echo. See, we are using echo because right now we are not printing the whole server array. Okay, we just want to use that particular index. So how we will use that? We'll use it like this, dollar underscore, then we need to write the array name, that is server, and now we need to write the index name. Okay, so what was our index? Okay, so here index, correct? So let's copy this and come here and paste it in. Okay, now we need to give, I guess, inverted, single inverted commas maybe. Let's see. And save this. Okay, now let's come here again. Okay, click in the URL and enter. Okay, now let's try to see, there is blank right now because we haven't put any input here and we haven't pressed the submit button. So let's once again put something in here. I'm putting my name only and password is 98765. And if I now hit submit, okay, cool, right? See, we refresh the page and we are in the same page right now also, server.php, and we are getting all the informations out of the array. So that means our function worked properly, this function. So this is used when we want to submit the form in the same page where it resides. If we want to refresh a particular page without navigating to any other page, then we can use this PHP self function. So this is how we can use the dollar server in various ways according to your need. So just go through each one of these indexes, see what suits you better for your best result. And we will see the other super global variables in the coming lectures, and that are the dollar cookies, dollar session, and the dollar file. So let's go to the next lecture and see what are those, and I will meet you there. Till then, thank you and have a great day.